Welcome back. We're talking to Paul J. Zak. He has written The Moral Molecule, and it is the source of love and prosperity. It is published by Dutton, and in a way, it comes to, have you recently received something in the mail that says, give for blind children, and you wrote a check, and you felt a little better? Well, maybe it was your oxytocin working. Welcome, Paul.
Thank you so much, Connie.
Thank you. But I love the whole idea that you begin, that you go to a wedding, and you're there to get people's blood.
That's right. We call this the vampire wedding. And it's a great illustration of actually how oxytocin works. So the question was, why would you ever spend $50,000 or $100,000 on a wedding? That's a down payment on a house, right? So I showed up in this wedding in southern England. I didn't know a soul, and I was wearing a white lab coat, and I had syringes and needles and centrifuges and dry ice. I took blood from the bride and the groom before and after the vows. Yeah. What we found is that these rituals induce the release of oxytocin, this chemical that we've shown makes you care about people, makes you feel empathy for them, makes you connect to them and want to help them.
How did you discover it in the beginning? I mean, what was the first clue to you?
Great question. So as a colleague of mine said 10 years ago, it was the world's stupidest idea that this hormone, only known in humans to be associated with birth and breastfeeding in women, would in fact have anything to do with regular life, and men for that matter too. But there was evidence in animals that in these social living creatures, oxytocin allowed for toleration of burrow mates. And I was interested in moral behaviors in humans. I thought, well, toleration into trust, generosity, compassion, maybe that runs on a continuum.
Yeah. But we should tell our friends that your primary source is economics.
That's right. My PhD is in economics, although I've undergraduate.